views and opinions expressed in the following program are those of the hosts and guests and not necessarily those of the staff and management of WWDB-TV.
Hello, and welcome to the latest edition of Real Talk with Rick Mannarino. I'm real excited about today's show. I have a wonderful guest, Judy Morio. Welcome, Judy.
Thank you. I'm really glad to be here.
To tell you a little bit about Judy, she is a real strong advocate of leadership, positive thinking. Judy has been involved with leadership, motivation, corporate speaking, and all those types of things. Very strong at it. Again, welcome. Welcome to the show. Thank you for being part of it today. And these are very tough times right now, and we're still going ahead and filming because we want to put some good information out to the public. And the subject that I really wanted to key on today is, during these tough times, it's very tough for us. It's very tough for everybody. A whole completely different world. And the leaders have to really step up and be an inspiration for others, to give them inspiration, to give them motivation, to give them the leadership skills to go ahead and raise their families and not be upset with kids that are, you know, messing the house up and running around and fighting and all that kinds of things. A lot of us aren't working. So I want to start by, how do you define a leader, Judy?
Well, I believe a leader is a person who sets the example for others of how things can be and makes decisions, sometimes hard decisions, and helps their people to think outside the box, to think creatively and to think differently. The leader is someone who kind of sets the standards.
Well, I know you've had a very successful career in motivational speaking. You have been an incredible leader throughout the world. Not only in the U.S., you've given information to people all over the world. What inspires you? What leaders do you like? What inspires you during these times?
Well, you know, these are very difficult times right now, Rick. They're times, we've never had a time quite like this in our lifetime that I know of, but we have been through some tough times previously. And so we have to remember that this too shall pass. Things get tough and then they get better and then that passes and then they get tough. And the thing the leader has to do is set a vision and help people to see that vision. Help people to see that this tough time is going to be over and things will get better. And so it's important for the leader to have a vision of these better times and to be able to communicate that vision to other people so that the other people have hope and they have they don't get so much fear.
Yeah.
Fear is so scary. You know, when people start getting caught up in their fear, then it's like a virus. It just spreads like negativity. It just goes from one person to the other to the other. And the leader has to make sure that that doesn't happen.
Yeah.
The leader has to be the person who's positive, who's showing people that there is a way, that there is always a way. There's another way. I've been fortunate. I was raised in a family of leaders. My mother was probably one of the most outstanding leaders I've ever seen. She was a woman far in front of her time. And even when she was in her 80s, she used to go to the senior citizens and she'd say, I have to go over there and help those old people.
And most of
them were younger than her.
Yeah.
But at 84 years old, she went back to school and learned to use a computer. And, you know, she always was thinking forward and she kept us, the children, always focused forward. She would say, don't look in the rearview mirror. You know, that's why they made the rearview mirror this big and the windshield this big, because you're supposed to look forward, not backward.
I like it.
And she would always say to us, look forward, set your goals, set your dreams, set your ideals. Know that things will get better. Everything is fixable. You can fix things when they're wrong, but you've got to do your homework. You've got to know what the facts are. You've got to know where you stand and know how to go forward. And I think that's been where I've been so extremely fortunate, is that I've had that that leadership from my mom and from my father, who was a real motivational genius. And the fact that I've been able to travel the world, like you say, I've spoken in 29 countries around the world.
God bless.
To some of the top leaders in the countries that I've been in. I've been able to work with senior executives in huge world banks all the way down to the newspaper boy that delivers the paper to your home or sells on the corner in some countries. And so it's been a big advantage to be exposed to all these different people in different positions around the world. And I've loved it. It's caused me to really study what makes people positive versus what makes people negative.
As a world leader and a motivational leader throughout the world, and very successful and very famous, who are the leaders you've looked up to other than your mom and your dad? I know that they had quite a great inspiration on you, but as you got older, who were the leaders you looked to for your inspiration?
Well, as I went through school, it was various teachers that I had. But when I got out of school and then as I started studying motivation, there were many motivational speakers that were quite instrumental in my, or influential, I should say, both instrumental and influential in my career. I was very fortunate to get to meet Og Mandino, who wrote the book, The Greatest Salesman on Earth, which you know is one of the most powerful motivational books in the world. And I sat next to him at a dinner one night, and I didn't realize that was who it was, because I actually thought that he had died. I didn't realize he was still alive. And when I met him, I went, oh, I thought you were dead. And he laughingly said, oh, my wife sometimes thinks I am too, you know. So that was really cool. Cabot Robert was another very influential person in my life. He was the founder of the National Speakers Association and a very good mentor to me, who helped me to get into this career. I met my most impressive leader of all times. I met in South Africa. I had the good fortune to work for newspapers in South Africa, and I got to see Nelson Mandela walk free from prison. I got to speak with him several times during my time with the newspapers. And I think out of all the leaders in the world, he was the most incredible leader of all times. The man had a vision like no one else I've ever known. He saw freedom for all of his people. He saw the right for his people to have education. And he saw coming through the horrible end of apartheid, that horrible situation they had in South Africa, he saw in his mind the end of apartheid, and he saw freedom for all his people, and he lived to make it happen. Yeah. And that's what was so incredible about it. You know, sometimes we can imagine things, but can we really live and make a whole country change?
Oh, goodness.
And can we take people through this horrible change that they had this terrible time and not have a bloodbath, but actually come through it with peace? And walk out the other side.
Amazing man.
I was amazed at him. And yet he was such an humble man. He would, if you were sitting at the table with him at dinner, he would make sure he introduced himself to you and to everyone. And he would ask questions about who you were and what you were doing and where you were from. And I think that's one thing that leaders really do, is they ask good questions. They find out about people around them. They find out about the world, and they listen. They're very good listeners. And that's very important for a leader, to be a good listener, especially a leader of an organization that has people that report to them, or let's say someone in a high position in the military. They all need to listen well.
Absolutely.
Because you never know where good information is going to come from.
Yeah.
You just never know.
I totally agree with you about being a good listener. And great leaders are always very engaging. Like you say, you're at a dinner with a big group of people, you always be able to identify the leader and that person that is engaging and wants to engage everybody. I always find that a leader wants to engage everybody. It's just not about, I'm the great Og Mandino and, you know, I'm going to speak here and I'm going to hold court.
No,
they don't want to hold court. They want to know about you.
Yeah.
And the funny thing about that is that I've found is you may meet people like that. You may be in a big group. They will ask you about you. They will want to know about
exactly.
you. And they will follow it up with a text message a phone call, they'll get your phone number, and they'll ask you again. They'll say, so great to meet you. It was a great conversation. That, to me, is a great leader. What I'm really curious about is, this question is very prominent in my mind right now. Did you ever ask Nelson Mandela how did he make it through all those years
in
prison? It was, what, 27 years?
You would say that to me. I did. It was 27 years he was in prison. And
how did he make it? What did he do? How did he keep his mind strong?
I did. I asked him that because I wanted to know how you could come through 27 years of prison and not be bitter and not have that hatred for your fellow man. Because he didn't. He didn't have any of that. And he said, I visualized every day. I saw my goal. I visualized it in my mind. I saw it happening every day. And I always knew the day would come when I would walk free. I never doubted it. He said, I saw it in my mind every day. And I thought to myself, if he could see in 27 years of being in prison, if he could see himself walking free, if he could see himself changing his country, if he could see himself getting freedom from all his people, why on earth can't you and I visualize the things that we want and have it come true, have it happen?
Yeah. You know, it's funny. I was reading something about him several months ago, and he was saying that they made a mistake, the government, in putting him in prison. They put him with a bunch of other leaders, and his group was a bunch of other leaders. They put all the diplomats, you know, in his party in the same cell. And they would sit every day and keep each other positive and lead. Did you ever speak to him about that?
Yes, he did. I did hear him say that.
Yeah.
I did hear him say that the mistake they made was in leaving them together.
Yeah.
Because them being together as a team, these were the same people that he was with in the African National Congress. You know, I mean, these were people who had been fighting together for freedom. So when they put him in prison, they put him all in there together. And he said, because they were basically a team, they were able to keep encouraging each other and keeping the faith and helping each other to maintain that positive energy that it was going to happen, that they would walk free. And they did. And he said, had they been separated where they weren't able to talk to each other or to support each other, it might have been a different story.
Wow.
Yeah.
It's very tough to defeat the power of positive thinking.
It is.
The power, as we're talking about leadership. And in talking about leadership, I wanted to take a moment to talk to the audience a little bit. I know these are very tough times, and it starts with the family. Leadership right now starts with the family, because you're home with your families, your significant others, your children, your parents, who's ever living with you, and it can become very tense. People are used to going off to their jobs and going to the park, going to the movies, going bowling, whatever they're doing. We're not allowed to do that right now, and it is a very tough time, and we all need to be safe. So please hang in there and be a great leader in your family. I can't recommend that enough. As the head of a household, be a great leader. Don't get irritable with the rest of your family. I know in my family, my daughter said to me today, Dad, I am enjoying being home from school so much because we do something every day. We walk the dog, we play board games, we talk, we'll watch a good movie together. So talking about leadership and our subject today being that with a great leader, I really want to recommend to all of you, please, please, please have the patience, stay patient, be a leader, be positive. And to further that, what would you recommend to the family unit and how to keep it strong and together?
I'm glad you asked me that, because, you know, when we talk about Mandela visualizing things, I just was working with a group of my coaching clients on what to do at home during this time.
Perfect.
While people are all kind of crowded in together and don't know quite what to do. And I recommended, and a couple of my stay-at-home moms told me it really worked for them, was that they go ahead and help their kids make vision boards. You know, to get out a big piece of a cardboard or a piece of poster board and a bunch of magazines and some scissors and some glue, and then ask the kids, you know, what do you want to be when you grow up? Where do you want to go? What do you want to do? What do you want to have? And then go through the magazines and cut out pictures and paste them on the board and put it up on the wall where they can look at it year after year after year and see. And I put my vision boards in a book, in a journal. Some people put theirs on their phone. They actually put it as the, what do you call that, the first page on your phone? It's like your screen.
Yeah, right.
They put their vision board
there.
Your
screensaver.
Yeah. And or they might have it on their computer, on their screensaver. In fact, it's interesting. I was watching Steve Harvey. I love Steve Harvey. And he said that he wrote down 300 things that he wanted to have happen in his life. He wrote down 300 things. Wow. And he put the piece of paper away. And a year later, he took it out. And he said it was amazing how many of those things had happened. And he challenged us to do that. And I did it and put it away, like he said. And he said, over 10% of it will happen. Well, sure enough, the following year, I pulled it out, and over 30 had happened.
Wow.
So it was like 36 had actually come true. So it's like you've got to get it in your mind that that's what you want and get it down. And I really recommend making that vision board and looking at it every day.
It's a great idea.
And, you know, if you'll do that with your kids and kind of divide their life up into different things, like, what do you want your career to look like? What do you want your home to be like one day? What do you want your fun and recreation to look like? How would you like your health to look? How would you like your spirituality to be? And have them cut out pictures from all those different areas
awesome.
Of their life and paste them on that vision board and put it, you know, where they can see it. Because
yeah.
If they'll look at it on a regular basis, it'll be amazing.
That's a great idea.
What you're doing for the kids. You know, one of the things my dad used to make us do, he made us read positive mental attitude books. And I think it was one of the strongest things that ever happened for me was to read those books by Og Mandino, by some of the great salespeople, Tommy Hopkins, by, I mean, the biggest names in the business,
Zig Ziglar,
yeah. You know, these people.
Les Brown.
Oh, Les Brown's one of my favorites.
All and, great leaders.
And to read their books or to watch them on YouTube nowadays or to look at some videos or something that they've done, it's one of the best things you can do for your kids because you're teaching them about positive things. And the world is so negative. I mean, in the average workplace, we hear a minimum of 5 negatives every hour. And so if it takes between, and research tells us, it takes between 14 and 20 positives to overcome the effects of one negative. I mean, do the numbers. You're talking 5 an hour times an 8-hour day, that's 40 a day. And what is 14 times that or 20
yeah.
times that, you know, the numbers are
it's staggering.
Incredible how much negativity is out there. And especially right now,
yeah.
where
it's
over
tough.
50% of what we're seeing on TV and on online is all about negative things and what's going on in the world and how horrible it is. And this is when we really need to focus on the positive. We really need to be looking at you know, how to get our kids focused on things that are good.
Yeah.
And things that can help them be a better human being and be a better person. And maybe right now while you're at home is another good time to make a list of what you're grateful for or to write thank you notes to people. Maybe they should write a letter to the grandparents that say, you know, I've really appreciated you. This is a time that we can teach them a lot of life skills that they don't even get in school. Because
yeah.
while they're home, well. Maybe life skills would be a really, really good thing. Another leader I just thought of, when I was working in Africa, I worked at a huge newspaper group. I was in the head office there, and so consequently I worked with 17 different newspapers from all different cultures
wow.
in their country. And one of our newspapers had 9 different tribes of black people represented in the group and 2 different tribes of white people. So we had people from 11 different cultures working in this one newspaper. And what I thought was interesting was that my boss spoke all 11 languages. And when I said to him one day, how come you speak, how did you learn to speak all 11 languages? He said, I studied. I said, well, why would you study to speak all 11 languages? And he said, would it be fair for me to be able to communicate with some of my people, but not all of my people? He said, if people work for me, shouldn't I be able to communicate with them? And so I learned their language.
Wow, that's amazing.
And I thought about, you know, how many times in this country I've been working in large groups and there'll be people from other cultures that work there and their bosses don't speak their language And the boss says, well, they're in our country, they should learn to speak our language. Well, we all know learning to speak another language when we're an adult is quite difficult.
Yeah, it's a task.
And so, you know, I really admired that man for making the effort to be able to talk to everyone, to be able to understand what they were saying.
Wow.
That blew me away. I wish I had a capacity for other languages. I've been studying Spanish for like 5 years now, and I still can't speak it fluently. Still can't. But it's
nor can I.
Yeah.
Nor can I.
But it's just that, you know, at least make the effort.
Yeah.
If you've got people
that
work for you that don't speak your language, make the effort.
That's truly a great leader there.
I think it
to
is.
To learn all 11 languages because he had 11 different tribes.
I think that's
tribes.
Leadership.
I mean, you've talked about a lot of leaders. You're a great leader. You're a great motivator. What do you find in all the leaders you've met, all the motivational speakers you've met? What is the one quality that they all have that makes them similar?
I believe there's more than one quality, but I think the first thing is vision.
The most compelling quality.
I think the first one is vision. They
vision.
Have that vision of how things can be, how
yeah.
things can be better. The second thing I believe that they have is good communication skills. They learn how to communicate with people, and they make the effort to do that. And the third thing is an ability to think creatively, to think in different ways, to see possibilities, not to settle on the first right answer, but know that there might be more than one right answer,
yeah.
and that in one circumstance, one answer might be better than another. So I think those three things are the things I've seen in the people I've dealt with around the world. And I think it's great that you call me a leader. I love being a leader.
Well, you are. I mean, you have done some incredible things in life. And as I told you all as an audience, I am honored to have Judy here today because she is really, really, really one of the most dynamic speakers, motivational leaders in the community, again, around the world. And, you know, it's just so much fun having you here, and I thank you for taking this interview. I'm kind of curious, you as a leader, do you have any new projects you're working on? What are you working on currently, and where are you speaking, and how's
yeah.
everything going with all the people you coach? What's going on for you right now?
Well,
I want to know a little more about
well,
that.
Well, right now, you know, huge groups of people can't gather,
yeah.
and so therefore I'm not out there speaking. But it was interesting that it happened at this time because I'd already basically decided that I was going to pull back from speaking to groups and to go more online. And I'd already started my online programs before all this quarantine happened.
Oh.
And I really am loving it and enjoying it. I'm doing group coaching online. I'm doing individual coaching online. I'm working with companies. I'm working with executives from large companies. And I'm working with individual people. I have a housewife in Canada, for instance, that I'm working with. And I love it because it's giving me the opportunity to speak with people worldwide. You know, I love this being online because
yeah.
there's so many ways to communicate online. I love Zoom. I love Skype. I mean, it's the ability to see this person on the other side of the world, or to have four or five or six people from different places in the world all on the screen
yeah.
at one time, all talking to each
Amazing.
Other and having our opinions on what we can be doing to make the world better. I love that.
Yeah.
And so, yeah, and it's interesting because I started a Facebook group called the Achieve More Method. And in case anybody wants to join it, please do. It's called the Achieve More Method, and especially if you want to learn how to do the vision boards with your kids. I'm doing a program on that this week on, it's going to be about a 20-minute here's how you do your vision board.
Okay.
So, you know, people can go online and look at that on Facebook on the Achieve More Method is what it's called. But I started this Achieve More Method group in December thinking that I would just put it together for a few people to come together and start seeing more positive things. And I put up daily affirmations and I give them written articles on positive things, and I also do videos and put them on there. And as of yesterday, I had 667 people who are now in the group.
Congratulations.
Yeah, I mean, it's
just started
like
it
so fast that it's grown.
Well, it's a great concept.
But yeah, people
really
love the
concept.
Positiveness of it, you know, and they share their own things. They put their own poems or their own stories or their own ideas there as well.
Yeah.
And so it's not just me. It's everybody's trying to focus on the positive, and I love doing that. And I'm hoping to build that group to a few thousand people. That would be awesome to have all these positive thinkers out there.
Yeah, it's very interesting. I mean, what other things do you have going on? Tell our audience how they can get in touch with you, and you know, the different areas that they can meet up with you. And I highly recommend that you try to get in touch with Judy, because she is a game changer. As positive as they come, and we all have problems that come up. All of our lives are never perfect, and it's great to be able to have somebody, a go-to person like Judy. Let our audience know how they can get a
hold
of you.
Thanks, Rick. Yeah, you can get me Judy, J-U-D-I, at judymoreo.com, and that's J-U-D-I-M-O-R-E-O. It's like Oreo cookies with an M. So it's Judy at judymoreo.com. You can get me there. Also, join my Facebook group, the Achieve More Method. It's free, and I'd love for you to be a part of that. And I've done a free webinar that's online as well. It's called Developing Your Personal Power and Reaching Greater Levels of Success. And if you go into the Facebook group, you can get the link to go over and see that that webinar free of charge. Right now I'm looking more to get my message out there to the world and to get people being more positive. I mean, right now is not a time to be thinking about making money. Right now is a time for each and every one of us to be thinking, how do we heal the world? How do we heal what's going on? And how do we help each other get through these tough times? That's what it's about. So most of the things you'll find from me online right now are free. And
so I
really recommend that. That they go there, get involved in the Facebook group, go and listen to the webinar, because the webinar will really help you deal with change.
Yeah.
Because change, that's another thing that great leaders do. They know how to deal with change.
Yeah. It's wonderful. And please, I highly recommend that you do learn and train with Judy. And as a matter of fact, I've been one of her students for many years. And I've had the opportunity to become a motivational speaker, leader, inspirational leader. And Judy has been very, very instrumental in my success. And I, along those lines, I wanted to ask you, if somebody wants to be a motivational speaker, if they want to train, they had that thought that they're very positive and they want to lead, they want to inspire, they want to motivate, how can they get a hold of you on that particular thing? Are you still training motivational speakers?
Yes, I do.
I believe you have some classes, right?
I do not only the training of the speaker on how to speak, but I also teach them how to go out into the marketplace and get booked. And I do about every 4 months, I do a two-day program where they can come and spend 2 days with me. I do small groups, only 8 people maximum to the group, and they can come and spend 2 full days, and we hone up their speaking, and we look at how they can go into the marketplace, where they should go, how they should target, what they do, and hopefully they can make some money doing it as well. So, you know, it'd be nice to be able to have a great message and get it out to the world, but people do also have to eat. You know, they have to pay their rent.
Yeah,
so it's good
to turn it into an income.
If they can do it as a business and make money, I do help people do that. So they can get me, you know, same thing, Judy at judymoreo.com, and I'll get right back to them.
I know you will. In the meantime, are there any books that you would recommend that they could read to get started if somebody's kind of like that idea, well, maybe I want to be a motivational speaker. People say that I'm really good at this. Are there books that they can read beyond calling you? Or what can they do to start to see if it's truly for them?
Well, I wrote a book called Turn Your Speaking Into Cash, and it's how to brand and market your speaking expertise. And they can get that on Amazon. I have another book, Turn Your Story Into Cash, which is about how to write your book. And it's a 4-step program on how to write your book and get it into the marketplace so that people see you as the expert that you are. And that is also on Amazon. And of course, my all-time bestseller, You Are More Than Enough, Every Woman's Guide to Purpose, Passion, and Power.
Oh,
that's
beautiful.
That's a book I recommend to everyone. I think it's I've even had men say to me, you know, why did you write this only for women? Or, you know, if I'd have read this book 20 years ago, I'd have been more successful too. Right. So right now, during this time I'm quarantined, I'm working on a book for men and women both. It's entitled You Are More Than You Think You Are, and that'll be coming out in September.
Wow. Congratulations. How many books have you written?
Well, for myself, I've written 17, and then I've ghostwritten for other people. So I do. I also do editing for people. You know, I help them with their books. If they can just get their thoughts down on paper or get their thoughts recorded, then I can help them turn that into a book. And so, like right now, I'm working with Kim Bullock Hennicks. I'm working with Kim on her new book called The Ambitious Woman.
Okay.
So that's kind of a fun one that I'm working on right now with her. She's written the book. I'm just helping her with the editing. But it's, I love helping other people.
I know you do. You're helping me with my first book.
I know. And it's going to be so good. Aren't you proud of yourself?
Well, I've got a little further to go. And, you know, it's not as easy as you think it is. Like, and the way you line it out, and again, for the audience, if you really have ever thought about writing a book, whatever it is on motivation or anything, Judy is an expert. She teaches you how to line everything out, your chapters, titles, how you proceed with it. And I'm currently going through the process, and it's exciting. It's challenging, but we're coming along. And I know you're checking on me all the time, seeing what is our deadline, July or something.
Yeah.
So.
Yeah, I do check on you, don't I?
Oh, you do. Well, you know, that's what, again, great leaders do. And, you know, I want to thank you for being on the show today.
Thank you.
It's been a lot of fun. Is there anything else that you would like to add or tell our audience or anything that you would further like to talk about before we end up for the day?
Just the main thing is I want you to remember that tough times do pass and that you are more than enough and you can get through this and we're all going to come out on the other side and it's going to be an even better earth than it's been before. We're going to have a good world again. You're going to see. Just hang in there.
Thank you, Judy. It's been such a thrill to sit with you today and have this great discussion. You are a wealth of knowledge and such a motivational leader. And I thank you for being on the show and taking the time.
Thank you, Rick.
You're welcome. I want to thank you all for joining in today. I, you know, was very excited about this show, and I'm even more excited about it now for you to engage in it and look at it and learn from Judy. Again, get a hold of her. You can't go wrong. She's very, very wanting to help out people. Great person, great leader. We thank you for joining the show today. Stay safe. Again, enjoy your families. Be tolerant of your families. Don't be overreacting. Enjoy life. Stay safe. Stay healthy. God bless you always. Thanks for tuning in.